आचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्तिप्राणालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः अथ जीवन मुक्ति विदेह मुक्ति वर्णनं नाम सप्तमस्तरंगः. सो सेवेंथ वेव इन विचार सागर मीनिंग द सेवेंथ चैप्टर इज अबाउट जीवन मुक्ति एंड विदेह मुक्ति. डिस्क्रिप्शंस ऑफ दोज, एलाबोरेशन ऑफ दोज. द क्वेश्चन दैट द शिष्य आस्क्ड इन द एंड ऑफ द टुवर्ड्स द एंड ऑफ द सिक्स्थ चैप्टर इज दिस द्वैत अनुभव विच लीड्स टू दुख संसार कंटिन्यूज इवन आफ्टर दिस ज्ञान. सो वॉट इज द उपाय? सो अस्ति कश्चन उपाय सेट द गुरु. वॉट इज दट उपाय? ज्ञानमेव उपाय. नो अदर उपाय अदर देन ज्ञान विच हैज ऑलरेडी बीन गिवन. सो मनन निधिध्यासन इज नीडेड दैट विल टेक अवे दुख. सो दुख निवृत्ति ज्ञानेन भवति. आत्यंतिक दुख निवृत्ति ज्ञानेन भवति. नित्यं सुखं कथं प्राप्स्यते? व्हाट अबाउट दिस नित्य सुख विच हैज बीन सेट टू बी अनदर एस्पेक्ट ऑफ मोक्ष, जीवन मुक्ति आनंद. सो दैट इज ए कॉन्टेक्स्ट इन विच दिस चैप्टर हैज कम अप एज टू डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन जीवन मुक्ति एंड विदेह मुक्ति ऑल्सो. बट कॉन्टेक्चुअली आनंद, हाउ डू यू गेट आनंद? ज्ञानिनो व्यवहार नियमो नास्ति. पूर्व पीठिका. सो इट बिगिन्स विद व्हाट इज द नियम फॉर अ ज्ञानी हु इज अ जीवन मुक्त. व्हेन एन अज्ञानी इंडल्जेस इन एनी एक्शन व्हाट इज द बेसिस? द ट्रायड इज अविद्या काम कर्म, अज्ञान काम कर्म. It is all for ananda. The basis for it is ajnana. Jnani does not have ajnana. Then what is his karma due to? We saw there is a lesha in the earlier chapter. Now puro pitika to this is the introduction says uttama madhyama kanishtha adhikaris have been discussed in the earlier chapter. So uttama madhyama kanishtha ka uttama madhyama kanishtha naam adhikarana. Give me just a moment, my monitor is twisted. Okay, uttama madhyama kanishtha naam adhikarinam trayanam ittham guru upadesha shravanadevir nissamshayam ayam atma eva brahma iti ati uttamam jnanam babuva. For all these three there was jnanotpatti. What was the jnanotpatti? It was samshayarahita as well, nissamshayam ayam atma eva brahma. What is being taught is this atma which is known by me aparokshataya, that itself is brahma as taught in the shruti as jagat karana. And how did this jnana take place? By guru upadesha shravana इत्यादि मननिधिध्यासन त्रयाणाम अपि एतेषां गुरुपदेशे समानेपि ब्रह्मसाक्षात्कारः उत्तमस्य तत्त्वदृष्टेरेव अभूत. दि थ्री उत्तम मध्यम एंड कनिष्ठ अधिकारी the three brothers, Uttama was Tattvadrishti, Madhyama was Adrishti, Kanishtha Adhikari was Tarkadrishti. Fourth, fifth and sixth chapters respectively dealt with it. Now, who got the Ati Uttama Jnana? What is the meaning of Ati Uttama Jnana? There is a gradation only in Jnani, not in Jnana. But why is it said Ati Uttama Jnana? Based on whether the Jnana is Paroksha or Aparoksha also you can make a gradation. Based on whether or not the Jnana is Aparoksha ridden with obstacles or Aparoksha not ridden with obstacles also is another reason for gradation. Thereby, Uttama Jnana, meaning Jnana without any obstacles, Aparoksha Jnana without obstacles, was only for the Uttama Adhikari. Trayana api etesham gurupadesha samane api. Brahma sakshatkara uttamasya tattva drishtereva abhut. Brahma sakshatkara then and there was only there for one who has an Uttama Adhikari. Because the others had commitment towards different things. Thereby Jnana is not sthira. So Sakshatkara does not take place. What is called as Aparokshanubhuti, Sakshatkaraha, Anubhavaha, Aparokshajnanotpatti. All this is to indicate that the person is Jivan Mukta. Although in Shastras, when Bhagavan Shankaracharya, in his Bhashyas, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says that Jnanena Muktihi and that Mukti is Jivan Muktihi, he does not disagree with Krama Mukti. Most of the places, the Upasana Khandas, in which are there very much in the Upanishads themselves, they are given a leg by. So Upasanas are not done. Thereby sthirata is not possible. Sthirata is only, you know, for few moments when someone is inquiring into this, sitting idle, feels happy about it, and that's about it. Back into samsara. Thereby what happens is that jnana sthirata lacking, the doubts pop up again. The indulgence is again and again, and then samsara continues. Videha Mukti is possible, Jivan Mukti, Ananda is not possible. So in the very technical sense, he is not a Jivan Mukta. Jivan Mukti, Ananda, elsewhere is said to be the reason to be called as a Jivan Mukta. Do you have Ananda right now in any circumstance? Anything surrounding you, do you have Ananda now? That is the question one should ask oneself. Otherwise, just like we have in Vyakrana, we have Laukika Vyutpatti for Rudhi Artha and the Yogika Artha. So, by derivation, it can mean. So, you have Jnana, therefore Jivan Mukta. This is the general case. But if you look into Ananda, not by derivation, by Anubhava, do you have Ananda? That Ananda cannot be any Ananda other than Swarupa Ananda, because you know that nothing else exists. Nothing else is a source of Ananda. But it is manifest. Now, why is Ananda so important? First of all, it is the pursuit. It is the end goal of each and every pursuit. Furthermore, it is not Vishaya Ananda, which is Nishiddha. So Ananda is Swarupa Ananda, which is encouraged. It is not a trap anymore. Unless one says that I have to have Samadhi, which is also Vishaya Ananda finally, because you are hankering after it. Samadhi becomes a Vishaya per se. So unless one is going around and looking for something else, what will be there is one's own self, which will, as long as prarabdha is there, which will be reflected as अनुभूत आनंद और आनंद फिट टू बी एक्सपीरियंस्ड. नाउ दिस इज जस्ट अ बैकग्राउंड, दिस इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल टू एवरीवन दो. सो जीवन मुक्ति विवेक इन दैट ग्रंथ भगवान विद्यारण्यचार्य टॉक्स अबाउट दिस. नाउ हियर दैट इज टेकन एज अ बेसिस एंड देन देयर इज अ फर्दर डिस्कशन टेकिंग पूर्व पक्ष. नाउ हियर तत्वदृष्टि इज मुक्ता बिकॉज ही हैज हैड ब्रह्म साक्षात्कार. वृक्षस्य शुष्कानि पर्णानि पतितानि यथा वायुनेतः ततः ऊह्यन्ते तथा उह्यन्ते तथा प्रारब्ध कर्म शेषवशात् नाना कर्म कुर्वत् ज्ञानिनः शरीरमपि इतस्ततो नियमानं यो प्रतिभाति. नाउ फ्रॉम द ऑनलुकर्स पर्सपेक्टिव दिस ज्ञानी इज स्टिल कंटिन्यूइंग शरीर. सो व्हाट एवर शरीर धर्म इज देयर विल बी आरोपित ऑन द ज्ञानी हु इज ब्रह्म वेद ब्रह्मैव भवति. हाउएवर द पर्सन हु इज लुकिंग एट ज्ञानी सीज द शरीर एंड देयर बाय दे कंसिडर हुएवर इज लुकिंग एट अ ज्ञानी दे कंसिडर दैट ज्ञानी हैज अ शरीर. सो वृक्षस्य शुष्कानि पर्णानि पतितानि यथा वायुनेतः. ऑल्दो दीज हैव बीन ड्रॉप्ड द लीव्स विच आर ड्राइड हैव बीन ड्रॉप्ड ऑफ द ट्री स्टिल वायुनेतः उह्यन्ते दे आर कैरिड द लीव्स आर कैरिड. सो लीव्स आर देयर दे आर कैरिड तथा प्रारब्ध कर्म शेष वशात नाना कर्म कुर्वत् ज्ञानीय शरीरमपि इतस्ततो नियमानं यो प्रतिभाति. द बॉडी हैज बीन ड्रॉप्ड बाय द ज्ञानी जस्ट लाइक द वृक्ष हैज ड्रॉप्ड द लीव्स ड्राइड लीव्स. द ड्राइड लीव्स आर यूजलेस फॉर द वृक्ष, इट इज अ बर्डन टू कैरी सो इट ड्रॉप्स इट. सिमिलरली ज्ञानी ड्रॉप्स द शरीर नॉट लिटरली but the tadatmya sambandha, he drops the tadatmya sambandha with the sharira. Sharira still continues just like the leaves still continue to be blown by the wind. The sharira continues to be blown by the prarabdha vataha. So prarabdha karma shesha vashat nana karma kurvat. Sharira will keep on doing what it does best, what it has always been doing. Guna guneshu vartante iti matva na sajjate, jnani tu na sajjate, still karma kuruvat shatranta, still he is doing jnani na shariram api. So what is that? Who is doing it? Sharira is doing it. Shariram kuruvat, neuter it is, it is not kuruvan. So here it is, karma kuruvat jnanina shariram api itastato niyamanam yo pratibhati. So it appears as though jnani is still carrying his load of the sharira. Jnani hi kadachit ratha. So you have to imagine, you know, just on this example itself, if the wind is blowing towards the tree itself, the leaves, dried leaves which have been felled off the trees, they will still stick to the tree. What will it appear? Oh, there are a lot of leaves on the tree. Suppose it. Similarly, it appears that the jnani is doing karma. So that is the example to say that jnani does not have karma, but prarabdha vashat continues. Jnani hi kadachit rathavaji gajadhyarudhasan वनारामादीन पश्यति. कदाचित् वन कदाचित् विना अपि पादरक्षां संचरति. सो ही मे लिव लाइक अ किंग ड्यू टू प्रारब्ध और ही मे लिव लाइक अ वॉन्डर विदाउट एनी पादुका इत्यादि. तस्य शयनासनादिकम् अपि अव्यवस्थितम् एव. What are the times to sleep, where to sleep, all this can be based on prarabdha. There is no decision to make per se. फॉर उत्तम ज्ञानी हियर तस्य कदाचित भोग भोजनाद्युत्तममेव भवति कदाचित सहस्रशधा तम पुरुषः प्रणमन्ति सो समटाइम्स यू नो ही मे हैव अ गुड एक्सपीरियंस ही मे हैव गुड फूड टू ईट डिलीशियस फूड नो यू मे हैव ही मे हैव नडपाका समटाइम्स नॉट इवन a morsel to eat and if he is like a king he gets a good range of food to eat good range of experiences he may not hanker of it but after it but prarabdha vashat it comes in bhiksha comes in and then thousands of people may also do namaskaras to this jnani kadachit ayam ubhay loka vrashta iti karmi bhir nindyate On the flip side, what happens? This fellow is neither here nor there. Gave up the grihastha ashrama, sannyasi life he is not able to live for whatever reasons. Prarabdha is such. Now this is possible for an ajnani also. He may appear like a jnani, but this is the case of the jnani. Sadhu is describing the case of a jnani who, due to prarabdha, some of the worst prarabdha is left which comes up later in life he has nothing to do with it but still there was an influence earlier which did not fructify so far but it starts fructifying post sannyasa what happens in a rare case ubhaya brashtha appears to be ubhaya brashtha neither here nor there not living a life of a sannyasi Grihastha ashrama he is already given up. He should not go back. There is no way. Shastra gives no way to go back to any ashrama after sannyasa. Sannyasa should be taken when everything is to be burnt, including one's own sharira, figuratively. One's own shraddha is done. Now, in which sharira will he go back? Figuratively again. There is no way to go back. Shastra tells this is sannyasa is only one way. If you want to go back, then you take another sharira in next janma. Meaning, if you want grihastha ashrama, you do it in the next janma. But appears not to be able to follow sannyasa dharma. Ubhaya bhrashtaha. Ye tavat tam pujayanti te tasya sukritam prapnuvanti. Ye tu tam dosha drushtya pashyanti te tasya papam ashnuvanti. And this is what Tattvabodha also says. It can be taken as arthavada. My internet seems to have gone. नमस्ते Are you clear? Okay, let's try this. I'm using this 3G. Let's see on hotspot. Okay, so what happens is he appears to be, Jnani, if he has a bad prarabdha, he may appear to be Ubhayabhrashta, but he is a Jnani, all right. Now what happens is that Tattva Bodha says that those who do puja of Jnani, Jnani Sharira, they get his punya, and those who agami punya, and those who do his ninda, mean those who criticize Jnani, they get his papa. So if he appears to be Ubhayabhrashta, meaning what? He appears to be doing papa, so that papa phala will not accrue to him. Why? Because he is a Jnani, he is not a karta anymore. If he is not a karta anymore, meaning he is not doing by choice, picking something, I need to do this with raga dvesha, because there is no ajnana, but it is getting done by the sharira, he finds himself doing something which he has nothing to do with really. So an uttama jnani's connection to the sharira, which is indulging, is same as some other indulging in papa. So some other sharira, somebody else's sharira doing papa, do you relate to it? However, Brahma has anuvritti there also. Brahma is vyapaka tattva, it is brahmatma, you are that atma. So if somebody is doing papa, are you associated with that papa? Punya also, but we are more focused here on papa. If somebody is doing adharma karya, whosoever it is, whether a friend or an enemy or a relative, do you partake of his papa? You don't. Why? Because you have nothing to do with that sharira karma. Similarly, Jnani has nothing to do with the sharira karma, not somebody else's, his own sharira. Because it is not his own sharira anymore, he has nothing to do with that sharira. This is the case of the uttama Jnani. Then there are gradations based on nishtha. Now, taking such a case, what happens to that papa which crops up? There is no claimant. Since there is no claimant, it is distributed among the followers. What kind of followers? Who follow the vyavahara of the jnani, they don't do it. They look at him and they criticize. Ubhayabhrashta, look at him. What kind of sannyasi is he? Etc. So this is the, end description, or the description at the end of Tattva Bodha. It can be Idamittam, as taken by many. It can be Arthavada also, to tell the people, you look at your own gunas and follow what you have to follow. Let the Jnani alone. You follow the Jnani who is doing what is appropriate. Do not follow the karma of anyone which is inappropriate, be it your own acharya. This comes up in Chaitanya Upanishad as well. So anyway, that's a deviation there. So ye tavat tam pujyanti te tasya sukratam prapnuvanti, ye tu tan dosha drushtya pashyanti te tasya papam ashnuvanti, itham jnani dehasya aniyatah vyavaharah. So what is this? What does begin with? Jnaninaha vyavahara niyamo nasti. What a jnani should do, there is no vyavahara niyama. This is the reason he drops off all karma and sets out. Otherwise, what happens is that if he stays in any particular ashrama per se and does not follow the ashrama niyama, then it will be bad for the social order. Dharmika social order. So thereby, itham jnani dehasya aniyataha vyavaharaha. What jnani deha does, nobody knows, because we ourselves do not know what circumstances we are going to come in. How we react also, we won't know right now. Only when you walk the path, you will know in a particular unimagined circumstance, how do you react. Jnani has no particular reaction per se, so Jnani Sharira, what it comes across, is based on Prarabdha. And it so happens that since Jnani has this janma as his last janma, prarabdha may flood. Most of what has, you know, what has been accumulated, carved out to fructify in this life, and jnani got jnana earlier in his life, in that last life, so to say, what will happen to the rest of the prarabdha karma? It may flood in. Anyway, so that's the reason that jnani dehasya aniyata vyavahara tattvavido brahma samshayadeyo naiva sambhavanti. However, jnani has no confusion there. Others may have confusion. Oh, why is he doing so? He has no such confusion at all. Who is doing it? So it may be lip service also, but again we have to remember this is jnani, because it is in the context of vichara sagara. The sadhu is talking about jnani, in whose case this may be possible, and he does not have brahma samshaya ityadi. Kadachit kutrachit api naivasti kinchit kartavyam tasya. He has nothing to do anywhere at any time. Yataha samagrataya tasya bheda brahma bhayadayo nashtaha. The bheda is nashta, brahma is nashta, bhayadi are nashta. There is no kartavya karma. Sarvottama veda pramana janita svaprakasha advitiya pratyak brahmatma aparoksha sakshatkaravan hi asau. Who is this person now? Who is that person? Jnani asau sarvottama veda pramana janita svaprakasha advitiya pratyak brahmatma aparoksha sakshatkaravan. He is sakshatkaravan. Sakshatkaravan means what? Sakshatkarah asya jnaninah asti iti sakshatkaravan. Kasya sakshatkar asti asya? Brahmanah, atmanah, that brahma which is atma, which is pratyak atma. So pratyak brahmatma, brahma which was paroksha, which is paroksha to everyone, tatpada vachyartha is lakshyartha now, which is his own pratyak atma. Therefore pratyak brahmatma, you see pratyak atma word, you don't see pratyak brahmatma. Here you see pratyak brahmatma, that brahma is his own pratyak atma ityartha. And is this sakshatkara as stated by the shruti? Yes, but is it remaining limited to only as stated by the shruti? No, it is aparoksha sakshatkara. Aparoksha and sakshatkara have the same meaning really, but to clarify, it is said aparoksha jnana sakshat krutaha nena jnanina. Thereby he has pratyak brahmatma aparoksha sakshatkara. What is it? Advitiya. It is svaprakasha. It is his own swarupa prakasha. And has it come off? No, by some coincidence, no, it is pramana janita. It has basis in Veda, in Vedanta Upanishad. So sarvottama Veda pramana janita. It is an uttama pramana, or it is uttama bhaga of the Veda, meaning the culmination. So Vedanta Upanishad. So Upanishad janya svaprakasha advitiya pratyak brahmatma paroksha sakshatkaravan asau jnani ityartha. Jnanino vyavahara aniyama apeksha akshepaha. So jnaninaha vyavahara aniyama. There is an akshepa on that. Jnanina samadesh sharira sthiti nirvahakat cha atirikte karyena pravrutyuktena bhavyam ityatra akshepaha. So sharira sthiti nirvahakat samadehe. So jnanina samadehe, what should he be doing? He should practice samadhi and focus on what? Sharira sthiti nirvah. So he should focus on sharira sthiti matra karma. Atirikte karye na pravrutti yukte na bhavyam. In other karya he should not take pravrutti. So this is the, let me just cancel the next class. I don't want to do two classes on 3G there. So what should he do? He should focus on his samadhi and not indulge in any other karma, not have pravritti in anything else except for samadhi and maintenance of his sharira. So he lives on as long as prarabdha is there. He goes ahead with prarabdha but steps aside and practices samadhi. He does not allow the other circumstances to crop up. This is some idea which many have. इति इत्यत्र आक्षेपः ज्ञानिनोपि व्यवहारे नियमोस्ति इति केचित् वदन्ति. सो ज्ञानी हैज व्यवहार नियम. व्हाट शुड अ ज्ञानी डू? सी व्यवहार नियम इज फॉर आश्रमस. वेदर इज ज्ञानी इन गृहस्थ इज इन गृहस्थ आश्रम और संन्यास आश्रम और अदर आश्रमस दैट आश्रम हैज नियम. ज्ञानी बाय हिमसेल्फ हैज नो नियम बिकॉज़ ज्ञानी इज ब्रह्म स्वरूप. ब्रह्म डज नॉट हैव एनी नियम. Can you say that Brahma should not continue in one sharira, it should continue only in another sharira? It's ridiculous. Brahma is same in the worst of the thieves and papis as it is in the devatas, in the jnani also. Thereby, Brahma cannot have a niyama. Jnani being Brahma, jnani cannot have niyama. This is the real reason why it is being mentioned. So now others do say that jnaninopi vyavahare niyamosti iti kechid vadanti triputi matram dukkha nidanam iti buddhva tat parityajya jnani sada samadhi nishto bhavati. Thereby what do they say? They say that this triputi, any triputi where there is a bheda vritti, triputi is where there is bheda, there is a triad. Jnani is one, the Prameya. So Jnani is a Pramata, then there is a Prameya Vishaya and there is a Pramana which connects the Pramata to the Prameya. This triad exists in each and every unit of knowledge, whether it is Shravana. Shravana will connect the Shravya Vishaya to the Shrota and so on. So Jnani's Prarabdha Sharira continuing, he has to be taking inputs from the sense organs, therefore the triad will continue. If the triad continues or sets of triads continue, he will keep on remaining pramata, becoming a shrota, manta, ityadi, drashta. Thereby what will happen? Triputi matram dukkha nidanam, dukkha karanam ityartha. It will be dukkha karana, will lead to dukkha, whereas jnani should be having sukha, moksha. Nityananda Swarupa. So Nityananda is no longer there if Triputi continues to be there. Iti buddhva tat parityajya, meaning Triputi matram dukkha nidanam iti matva buddhva tat parityajya. Triputi parityajya. Triputi parityajya. What will he do? So Triputim parityajya. Jnani sada samadhi nishto bhavati. This is an idea that they present. Yada vyavahara sambhavati tadapi sopi ashanaya pipasadi prayojya bhikshashana jalapanadi sharira sthiti karaneshveva nanyatra. So what is this vyavahara? Even if vyavahara is there, he should limit it to what? And he does limit it. That is what is being said. Sambhavati tadapi. What does he do? Sahapi. Just like others, he also indulges in karma. What kind of karma? Vyavahara. When hunger rises, he eats. Bhiksha time, he goes for food, brings in food, eats it. When he is thirsty, he drinks water so that the sharira continues. Nanyatra. Elsewhere, he does not have any pravritti. Nachasa vismarati kadachidapi samadhi sukham. He does not forget the samadhi sukha because he comes out of samadhi sukha. He comes out of samadhi meaning he leaves his samadhi sukha behind for bhiksha. No, he does not Samadhi Sukhai, he hasn't forgotten, so he'll go back to it. This is the idea. Anyway, there is a tippana there. There are two tippanas. So Jivan Mukti and Videha Mukti. The chapter begins with that, and there itself there are two tippanas in the name of the chapter. Jivan Mukti Lakshanam. Prapancha Pratiti Purvakam Pratyak Brahma Chaitanya Nishtatvam. What is Jivan Mukti definition? Prapancha Pratiti Purvakam Pratyak Brahma Chaitanya Nishtatvam. So, Jivan Mukti is where one has Nishtha. Nishtha in what? Pratyak Brahma Chaitanya. In one's own, again here, not Pratyak Chaitanya alone, Pratyak Chaitanya Nishtha is a yogi also, Sankhya also, a Bauddha also perhaps. Although he may not say Pratyak Chaitanya, they may call it Shunya. So let's drop him, but a yogi who is a Dvaitin is also Pratyak Brahma Nishtha in Samadhi. But is he Pratyak Brahma Chaitanya Nishtha? Pratyak Chaitanya Nishtha. Is he Pratyak Brahma Chaitanya Nishtha? He is Pratyak Chaitanya Nishtha. Does not know that his Chaitanya is Brahma Chaitanya. That is the yogi. Now there is another thing also. Yogi does not have Samadhi when he has Prapancha Pratiti. So Prapancha Pratiti Purvakam. Prapancha Pratiti is there preceding that. Anyway, this is a little tricky. Purvakam is a little tricky. It can be simultaneous as in the Jivan Mukta being there in samsara itself, meaning he is not run away to a cave. However, while being in the society, he is Pratyak Brahma Chaitanya Nishtha. That is his Lakshana, Jivan Mukti Lakshana, Jivan Muktasya Lakshana. Here Jivan Mukti Lakshanam, meaning what he has Jivan Mukti. What is the definition of that Jivan Mukti? It is Nishtatvam in Pratyak Brahma Chaitanya, which is Prapancha Pratiti Purvaka. Videha Mukti Lakshanam tu Prapancha Pratiti Shunyatve Sati Pratyak Chaitanyatmana Vartanam. What is Videha Mukti? Videha Mukti is when Deha is gone. Prarabdha is over, the Deha is dropped, and then Prapancha Pratiti, can it be there? No. Why? Because Prapancha Pratiti is possible only through Indriyas, through Sukshma Sharira. Sukshma Sharira is Bhoga Karanam and Stula Sharira is Bhogayatanam. Both Bhogayatana and Bhoga Karana, Stula and Sukshma Shariras, have withered away into their own basic causes, the Panchamahabhutas. When the body dies away. This is true partly for an ajnani. An ajnani's stula sharira is burnt and it goes back to the basic elements, but sukshma sharira continues across various stula shariras, various janmas, various kalpas, anadikalena. However, in Videha Mukti, what happens? The sukshma sharira also is resolved into its individual basic elements. Therefore, Videha Mukti Lakshanam Kim Prapancha Pratiti Shunyatve Sati. There is no Prapancha Pratiti, and what else is there? Pratyak Chaitanyatmana Vartanam. One remains as Pratyak Chaitanya, which can be said as Pratyak Brahma Chaitanya also, which is the same Chaitanya. There is no other Chaitanya there. Or it can be said as Brahma Chaitanya alone, there is no Pratyak anymore, because there is no innermost. There is no innermost. That innermost is the Brahma Chaitanya, Vibhu Chaitanya. Anyway, so going back to the Mula, Nasa Nachasa Jnani Vismarati, Kinna Vismarati, Samadhi Sukham Na Vismarati, Kadachidapi, Bhikshakale Api, Ashanaya Ashana Pipasa Velayam Api Saha Samadhi Sukham Na Vismarati Tyartha Tataha Adhika Sukha Bhavat. Because there is no other Sukha there. The hunger is a little disturbing to the Sharira. It disturbs the Samadhi, all right. But he wants the Samadhi Sukha. He just takes care of the disease called hunger feeds himself and goes back to samadhi. He never forgets that this food, however tasty it is, he does not forget that it is not the source of sukha. The source of sukha is Brahmatma, which I have already have anubhava of, and even now he has anubhava actually. But as a purva paksha or another paksha, what is being said? Tataha adhika sukha bhavat. There is no more sukha than samadhi, therefore jnani would not indulge in other karmas. Dukkha hetutvena triputya udvijate. Okay. Ataha samadhyartham eva jnani bhuyo bhuyo yatate. What should the jnani do? What does he do? He continues to remain in samadhi. He goes back to samadhi punah punah paunah punyena. Yastu samadhi sukham brahmato bhaihya sukhasaktya tyajati sa shvagardhava preta samayeva. So yastu samadhi sukham brahmataha bhaihya sukhasaktya tyajati. So bhaihya sukha asakti sukhasaktya. So bhaihya sukhasakti becomes the reason for the brahma. And thereby what happens? Or rather, there is a brahma, and what is that brahma? Bhaihya sukha. Sukha will give me more sukha than anything else. Samadhi that right now I have. Meaning what? There is vishaya sukha asakti. Thereby what happens? He gives samadhi sukha. He gives up samadhi sukha. Yastu samadhi sukham tyajati. Brahmataha. What is that? Through which he'll give up then bhaihya sukhasaktya. Saha shvagardhava preta samaha. He is equivalent to, you know these meanings. So gardhava is a donkey. So what is he equivalent to? Preta samaha ityadi. All has been used to only show that having gotten the sukha which everyone craves for, he gives that up and goes back to vishaya sukha, which is the nature of pranis. Even see preta. Who is a preta? Preta is one who has died from this sharira but does not get further gati due to whatever reasons. There is association with this body itself, or the karma is such that papa is so much that it gets tortured even to get any further gati. Karma is not done well, meaning the sharira has not got, you know, dahana ityadi. It has not got proper ritualistic treatment and yajnata. It has not done well, so he has become a preta. Now all that is due to his own prarabdha, alright. So he has become a preta. He has attachment to the earlier sharira. This is why the jiva has become preta. Meaning hanging in a trishanku avastha, neither here nor there, does not have the old sharira. New sharira is not prapta. That is the case of this jnani who gives up samadhi, which is already there. So if the jiva picks up the next thread as to what is my interest further, then he'll get further gati. That is the kind of prarabdha which will be carved out of the sanchita. Therefore it is said, you know, an accidental death does not let a person bring up his desires at the forefront. So there is no decision possible till a particular time as to what are his or her most intense desires. So there is a waiting period, so to say. You know, if we gahana karmano gati hi, but still if we have to logically analyze some part as to why a particular person becomes a preta, jiva becomes a preta, there is an attachment to some kind of thing which is useless really. Thereby this samadhi sukha being given up by the jnani makes him equivalent to that kind of a person, that kind of a jiva who is a preta or a gardhava. Thereby, what happens here now? There is a ninda done of a person, of a jnani, who gives up samadhi and indulges for sukha in vishayas. Gaudapada mandukya karikayam samadhi prakara saprapancham prapanchitaha. Ittham jnani prapancha vikshepa bhramam tuchhi krutya sakala sukha sagari bhuta swarupanandatma atmana eva avatishtate. So Mandukya Upanishad Karika says that samadhi is in this manner. Savikalpaka, nirvikalpaka, which is equivalent to the yoga samadhi. It is discussed by Bhagavan Gaudapada Acharya in Karika, the fourth chapter. So itham jnani prapancha vikshepa bharam tuchhi krutya. So what is the jnani's nature? He will give up the brahma, which is a vikshepa or due to vikshepa of the prapancha. Prapancha is not taken as real. Thereby he says that prapancha is not mithya. Tuchhi krutya. If it is said that it is mithya, still one may indulge. Here tuchhi krutya, it is tuchha, it does not exist at all for a jnani. Therefore sakala sukha sagari bhuta swarupananda atmana, swarupananda atmana swarupena ityartha. So swarupena avatishtate, he remains in his own swarupa. And what is that swarupa? It is sakala sukha sagara rupa. Ashtanga mantarena cha samadhi sukha nalabhyate. Ashtanga yoga is what leads to samadhi. Dharana dhyana samadhi is the last triad. When bahiranga sadhanas are done, they'll help one move into antaranga sadhana. Then antaranga sadhana is dharana dhyana samadhi. Samadhi sukha samadhi suswakaranatvad ashtangasya. This must be sukha. So samadhi sukha. This is not suswa. There is a typo here. Or misprint or whatever. It is samadhi sukha. So samadhi sukha karanatvad ashtangasya. That is a hetu for ashtanga yoga. So ashtanga mantarena cha samadhi sukham nalabhyate. Without the practice of ashtanga yoga, one won't get samadhi. Why? Because samadhi sukha karanatvad ashtangasya. Ashtanga goal itself is samadhi sukha. Asadharanam karanamantarena cha naiva karyam utpadyate. It is an asadharana karana. You cannot say that I'll not use what is necessary ingredient for a karya and still create karya. You cannot get it. You cannot say I'll create a clay pot without clay. It is an asadharana karana, material cause there. Without the kulala, you cannot get it. Or kulala vat, something should be there, like a potter. Machine created, machine itself is doing the potter's job. But you need someone there, asadharana karana, someone or something there. Ataha tanyuchyante shrunu. Therefore, these are discussed now. What is the means to samadhi? Pratyekam pancha pancha yamaniyamau. Aneka vidhanya asanani. Aneka vidah pranayamaha. Aneka vidah pratyaharaha. Dharana dhyanam samadhi savikalpakaha. Samyag asmin ashtange sadhite sukaraha syan nirvikalpaka samadhihi. नान्यथा अतः अवश्यम अनुष्ठेयम् तत् इत्थम समाधिर अवश्य अनुष्ठेयताम् श्रुत्वा भूताविष्टवद् एते अन्यथा कथयन्ति इति मत्वा तत्त्वदृष्टिः तूष्णीम् अनुक्त्वा किञ्चिदपि जहास. सो नाउ दिस तत्त्वदृष्टि हु वाज टोल्ड दैट फॉर दुख निवृत्ति व्हाट इज द मीन मींस ज्ञानमेव. However, for sukha utpatti, what does he mean? Samadhi. So, ashtanga mantarena cha samadhi sukham na labhyate. Therefore, ataha tani uchyante. What are those ashtangas? So, yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, samadhi. These are the ashtangas. Pratyekam pancha pancha yama niyama. So, first two are yama and niyama. They are five each. Five yamas, five niyamas. अनेक विधानि आसनानि. आसनास रियली स्थिरम सुखम आसनम. एज पर भगवान पतंजलि इन योग सूत्र स्थिरम सुखम आसनम. any asana where which can be easily accomplished, which is steady, and you can remain without dukkha there. So sukham also has the meaning, they're adverbial. Easily accomplished, easily maintainable, steadily, that kind of posture is called as what? Asanam. But still, for the asana siddhi, many other asanas are needed. So aneka vidhani asanani, aneka vidaha pranayama. Pranayama also, bhastrika, kapala bhati, anuloma viloma, all these are there. Whatever helps one remain steady in an asana where breathing is also smooth and it is slow. Longer the breath cycle, meaning lesser number of breaths per minute, longer the life. This is the goal of yogi. And also the kundalini rises when the breathing is shallow, is slow. Movements are also restricted. Anyway, that's an aside. Aneka vidaha pratyahara. So how to stop the bhaya pravritti and move inward? How to withdraw your sense organs? There are many ways to do it. So therefore, pratyahara is also many. Dharana, one dhyana, one samadhi. Meaning, dharana is on one particular thing. That is also aneka vidha, really. But for us, this is not a yogi's context. Yogi's tools are being used, which are shastra tools. Yogi made a darshan out of it. Stop there. We didn't stop there. We use these as tools for nididhyasana. Thereby, dharana is on what? Mahavakya. Dhyana is on what? On the culmination of that Mahavakya itself. Inquiry. Then samadhi fructifies, which is savikalpakaha, where the triad continues, vritti continues. Then samyak asmin ashtange sadhite, when the ashtanga is accomplished very well, what will happen? Sukaraha syat nirvikalpaka samadhi. Although the goal of samadhi is nirvikalpaka samadhi, meaning the definition of samadhi is nirvikalpaka, still it cannot be, because it is chitta vritti nirodha. When it is said chitta vritti nirodha, yogaha, yogas chitta vritti nirodha. When chitta vritti is not there, you cannot have triad. You cannot have triputi, then it cannot be savikalpaka. Thereby, although the nirvikalpaka samadhi is meant, savikalpaka has to be included. Therefore, savikalpaka is taken as the meaning, and then nirvikalpa will be possible only when savikalpaka samadhi, up to that. Savikalpaka itself is not going to be possible unless ashtanga yoga, other seven steps are followed well. Thereby, when all the eight steps are followed well, nirvikalpaka sukaraha syat. It will be easily accomplished. Nanyatha, otherwise it is not possible to get nirvikalpaka samadhi. Ataha avashyam anushteyam tat. Therefore, the ashtanga yoga should be practiced. Ittham samadhir avashya anushtiyatam shrutva bhutavishta vat ete anyatha kathayanti iti matva tattva drishtihi stushnim anuktva kinchidapi jahasa. So oha kyage, he gave up everything else, little akara, he gave up everything, and even kinchidapi, he was not doing anything else other than what? Tushnim anuktva, was not even blabbering around or talking much. He remained silent, and samadhe avashya anushtheyatam shrutva, having heard that, oh, samadhi should be practiced. Bhutavishtavat, as though possessed, ete anyatha kathayanti iti matva, others talk about in different ways, he remained silent and kinchidapi jahasa, give even a little. Asyam siddhanta, what is the siddhanta there? Naivasti niyamo jnanina sharira vyavahare tasyahi tada vyavahara hetu bhuta ajnana tatkarya bheda bhrama tajanya ragadveshadeva na santi. Jnani does not have ragadvesha, which have moola in Ajnana. So Ajnana Karya is Bheda. And Bheda causes Brahma. Brahma Janya Ragadvesha. All these are there for others, but Jnani does not have it. Therefore, Jnani does not have any Vyavahara. Vyavahara Hetu Bhuta. Ajnana Tatkarya Bheda Brahma Tajanya Ragadvesha Deva Na Santi Jnaninaha. Therefore, Jnaninaha Sharira Vyavahare Naivasti Niyamaha. He does not have any reason to indulge. He indulges because Sharira indulges. He has nothing to do with it. Kintu Prarabdham Karma Eva. एकम एव अवशिष्टम सो किंतु प्रारब्धम कर्म एकम एव अवशिष्टम ओनली वन थिंग इज रिमेनिंग प्रारब्ध कर्म देयरफॉर दैट टेक्स द शरीर तदेव च सदा तदेव च तदा तद्व्यवहार हेतु सो व्हाट इज द व्यवहार हेतु फॉर अ ज्ञानी नॉट राग द्वेष एज इन द केस ऑफ अदर्स इट इज ओनली प्रारब्ध कर्म व्हिच इज हेतु तादृशस्य च प्रारब्ध कर्मणः पुरुष भेदेन नाना प्रकारत्वात् प्रारब्ध कर्म जन्य ज्ञानी व्यवहारोपि नाना प्रकार एव स्यात् न नियतः यू कैन नॉट मेक रूल्स एज टू व्हाट शुड बी दी व्यवहार ऑफ दी ज्ञानी वाई बिकॉज प्रारब्ध इज अननोन प्रारब्ध आर मेनीफोल्ड देयरफॉर ज्ञानी इज व्यवहार इज मेनीफोल्ड इट हैज नो बाइंडिंग ऑन दी ज्ञानी इवन दो बीइंग मेनीफोल्ड बिकॉज ही इज नॉट अ कर्ता भोक्ता देयर बाय नो रूल कैन बी fixed niyataha there cannot be any rule ayam eva siddhanta paksha this is the real siddhanta kechidahu who are those sanyasina eva jnani mukhya adhikara iti vadantaha shankarananda pravrutayah so shankarananda bhagavan shankarananda is the guru of vidyaranyacharya what does he say so this is the orthodox view really the orthodoxy follows that view Other than orthodoxy, there are many sannyasis who do not have particular ashrama per se. They belong to a sampradaya, which is really one sampradaya, but still with the mathabhedas, there are different sampradayas. They follow various things, various shakhas also in Veda, various Upanishads also, various mantras also, various methodologies, prakriyas also. So all these bhedas are there. However, Orthodoxy follows the sannyasa niyama. Sannyasina eva jnane mukhya adhikaraha. So sannyasinaha eva jnane mukhya adhikaraha iti vadantaha shankarananda pravrutaya. These are the orthodox people who say that sannyasis alone have adhikara in Vedanta, in jnana. That is why Upanishad is usually not taught to a sannyasi, not taught by anyone but a sannyasi. University degrees are different. But moksha ichchu is one who is really not desiring anything else. Therefore, what should he be doing really? Sannyasi. He should take to sannyasa. Therefore, we have either vividisha sannyasa or vidvat sannyasa. One who knows and then takes sannyasa like Yajnavalkya. Or one who does not know and takes sannyasa to know. There is no third category in orthodoxy. The third category mentioned in passing is what? Janaka. There are other examples also. Not that there are no examples. But jnani mukhya adhikari. Mukhya adhikaraha sannyasine. Mukhya adhikara. Now this should not be missed. Others are also adhikari. Others also have adhikara. But not mukhya adhikara. They'll also get jnana. Tattva drishti here, tarka drishti as well as adrishti, they are not sannyasi. They are not talked about as sannyasis here. Because the sadhu does not agree per se. Kechid ahuhu. In a sense, vyakrana those who have studied, lopa shakalyasya. What does it mean? Shakalyasya munina matena lopaha bhavatyatra. Natu paninna matam. Etad matam paninna न उच्यते ही रिस्पेक्ट्स द रूल ऑफ अनदर ग्रामेरियन एंड सेज शाकल्यस्य मतेन लोपः न तु मम मतेन इत्यर्थः आई डू नॉट एग्री बट ही सेज आई देयर आर पीपल हु फॉलो इट वी रिस्पेक्ट देम आई पर्टिकुलरली से दैट हियर यू डू नॉट डू लोप बट व्हाट हैज हैपेंड लोप शाकल्यस्य इज यूज्ड थ्रू एंड थ्रू असावादित्य ब्रह्म देर यू डोंट सी असावादित्य वकार लोप हैज टेकन प्लेस सो यकार वकार लोप इज कॉमन असावादित्य ऑर्थोडॉक्सी फॉलोज वकार बीइंग देर एज वेल सो बोथ फ्लेवर्स आर अवेलेबल बट व्हेन यू से लोप शाकल्यस्य मीनिंग शाकल्यस्य मतेन शाकल्य सेज सो हियर केचिदाहु आल्सो मीन्स द सेम थिंग रियली व्हाट इट मीन्स इज दैट साधु प्रिफर्स द अदर पक्ष ही डज नॉट और रादर ही हैज अ डिफरेंट ओपिनियन देन दिस ही नीड नॉट एग्री विद इट सो केचिदाहु ज्ञानिनः विहित कर्मानुष्ठान नियमाभावेपि निषिद्ध आचरण निवृत्तौ नियमो अस्त्येव सो ज्ञानिनः विहित कर्मानुष्ठान नियमाभावेपि ऑल्दो देयर इज नो नियम सो दे से नियम मे नॉट बी देयर बट निषिद्धाचरण निवृत्तौ नियम अस्त्येव व्हाट ही शुड डू विच कर्म ही शुड डू विहित कर्म ही नीड शुड ही डू इट देयर इज नो नियम ही मे डू इट ही मे नॉट डू इट बट निषिद्ध आचरण शुड ही डू इट नो इट इज निषिद्ध फॉर एवरी वन इवन फॉर अ ज्ञानी ही शुड नॉट डू इट ज्ञानिनो हि प्रवृत्ति ही देह स्थिति हेतुभूत भिक्षाशन कौपीनाच्छादन मात्र ग्रहणे एव स्यात् न अन्यत्र सो वेयर शुड दी ज्ञानी प्रवृत्ति बी हिज प्रवृत्ति स्यात् हियर इज विधिलिंग एंड एज विधि ऑल्सो विधिलिंग नॉट विधि निमंत्रण आमंत्रण अधिष्ट संप्रश्न प्रार्थनेषु इट इज विधि ओनली नॉट शक्यार्थे लिंग विधि एव स्यात् सो एव कार टेल्स यू व्हाट would be is possible indeed it would be possible so or is it indeed it should be possible so in orthodoxy should jnaninah hi pravrutti deha sthiti hetu bhuta what is the hetu for deha sthiti for the sustenance of deha food therefore bhiksha ashana eating the bhiksha kaupina achhadana to protect oneself one needs something so the bare minimum clothing so that one can remain in the society also people don't shy away from you are not a naga sadhu there are people who don't have you know jainas or even in sampradaya we know of quite a few who didn't wear any clothes because clothes have no meaning where sharira has no meaning what meaning will a secondary sharira have or clothing it has no meaning but still to protect the sharira either the guru or someone else says please for you it has no meaning but for others let them get jnana from you they can't approach you if you are nagna digambara so thereby achhadana also is done there is a niyama you cover yourself at least bare minimum so achhadana matra garane eva syat na anyatra Nowhere else is there pravritti. Should be pravritti. There should be pravritti only in these, not in anything else. Even in this, if pravritti is not there, it's okay. But in nishiddha karma, you should not have pravritti. Yataha prageva jnanotpattir jijnyasa dashayam mumuksho sadhana chatushte sattvena tivra vishe dosha drushti vashad vairagyam sampannam eva. And here if you say, He would not have it also. Why would he not have any pravritti in other karya? Because before jnana itself, he has sadhana chatushtaya sampatti accumulation. He has siddhi of sadhana chatushtaya in jijnyasa dasha itself. Because he was a mumukshu, he gave up everything else. He was not a mumukshu also. Sadhana chatushtaya sattvena shamadamadi is there, already there. Therefore, tivra vishe dosha drishti vashad. Vairagya is also there. He has done dosha drishti as a sadhaka. Jnani does not need dosha drishti. Thereby, sampannam eva. Vairagyam sampannam eva. So, one who has vairagya, how will he indulge in other things? He wouldn't. So, would shakyarthe is also possible there. What is this vishaya dosha drishti we have seen there? So, janma mrityu jara vyadi dukkha doshanu darshana. So, comma is misplaced here. Janma mrityu jara vyadi dukkha doshanu darshanam ityadhyalochanam dosha drishti. We know the meaning. What is this dosha drushti? Seeing defects in every pursuit other than jnana. Janma is dukkha, mrityu is dukkha, jara is dukkha rupa, vyadhi is dukkha rupa. Therefore, dukkha rupa or dukkha itself is a dosha. All these are doshas and dukkha is a dosha. Or all these being dukkha, they are doshas. Following this darshana through and through, each and every time you hold on to this inquiry and see dukkha in all these, or see all these along with dukkha as dosha. Thereby what is said, there will be no pravritti as a sannyasi also, as a jnani also. Sorry, I missed it. Kechidahu, okay. Yeah, here. तादृक वैराग्यम ज्ञानोत्पत्त्यनन्तरमपि दोषदृष्टिबलाद् विषय मिथ्यात्व निश्चय वशाच्च दृढतरम् वर्तते. Since it was already firm, vairagya was already firm during sadhaka, sadhana avastha, as a sadhaka, it will continue as a jnani, it will become more firm but not loose. Therefore, दोषदृष्टिबलाद् विषय मिथ्यात्व निश्चयवशाच्च. विषय मिथ्या, बीइंग मिथ्या इज ऑलरेडी देयर. नाउ ही हैज व्हाट ही हैज तुच्छीकरणम. विषयज आर तुच्छ, नॉट मिथ्या एनीमोर. ही डज नॉट हैव टू इवन इंक्वायर नाउ. देयरफॉर द वैराग्य विल कंटिन्यू टू बी देयर. वर्तते अनुवर्तते ज्ञानदशायाम् अपि अद्वितीयात्म अपरोक्ष ज्ञानबलात् अनात्म पदार्थेषु तुच्छत्व निश्चये सति. So tuchchatva nishchaya takes place now in all the anatma padartha vishayas. How? Now there is additional bala. Earlier there was bala of dosha drushti which continues, and now he has bala of aparoksha jnana. Advitiya atma aparoksha jnana bala is additional for the jnani. Therefore this mithyatva nishchaya graduates to tuchchatva nishchaya. तुच्छत्व निश्चये सति अद्वितीय आत्मा परोक्ष ज्ञान बलात् अनात्म पदार्थेषु तुच्छत्व निश्चये सति पुनः पुनः पदार्थ सत्य सत्यता बुद्धिर् न जायते. सॉरी, पुनः पदार्थ सत्यता बुद्धिर् न जायते. ही विल नॉट हैव एनी कंसिडरेशन फॉर अ विषय, नॉट बिकॉज इट इज मिथ्या, इट डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट इन हिज पर्सपेक्टिव एट ऑल. देयरफॉर सत्यता बुद्धि is not possible in his case. Dosha drushti prabalye hi sati naiva rago jayate pravritti matram cha raga moolakam eva. So dosha drushti prabalye, there is prabalatva of dosha drushti. When it started increasing, prabalyam, the strength for dosha drushti grew as and when he was doing sadhana. In jnana avastha what happens? It has become very dridha. So it has become prabala. Therefore, dosha drushti prabalye hi sati naiva rago jayate, ragha naiva jayate. Pravritti matram cha, what is pravritti due to now? Pravritti matram cha ragamulakam eva. Raga is a necessary ingredient for pravritti. It should be preceding. Raga itself is not possible because dosha drushti is there in vishaya. Therefore, vishaye ragha na utpadyate. यतः रागः नास्ति तथा प्रवृत्ति प्रवृत्तिर् न संभवति. प्रवृत्ति इज नॉट पॉसिबल. ज्ञानिनो रागा संभवात् नैवास्ति प्रवृत्तिः. शरीर जीवनार्थ भोजनादि प्रवृत्तिस्तु विना एव रागं प्रारब्ध कर्माधीनतया एव जायते. हाउएवर व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट देयर इज आल्सो इन साधना अवस्था व्हेन वन इज हंग्री, वन वाज ईटिंग फूड, सो दैट कंटिन्यूज टू बी देयर. Prarabdha is there for the sharira to continue. As a sadhaka, one did not say that I'll not eat. It is not a 24 hour upasa. It is not 24/7, 365 days upasa. Once in a while upasa, no upasa, or a balance of upasa and food was there in sadhana avastha, which continues in jnana avastha also. It is prarabdha karma adhina. Thereby, there is no reason for ashana pipasa to cut. To be fulfilled. Karma cha sanchita agami prarabdha bheda trividam tatra atita ananta sharira anushtitam sat phalaya anarabdham. Anarabdham, sorry, phalaya anarabdham meaning prarabdham, is not there, anarabdham, karma sanchitam. What is sanchita? So sanchita, agami, prarabdha, these are the three varieties of karma. Tatra atita ananta sharira anushtitam sat phalaya anarabdham karma sanchitam. What is sanchita? Sanchita which has not prarabdha, meaning which is anarabdha, which has not begun fructifying. Phalaya na arabdham. And what is it? It is not somebody else's karma. Atiyeta ananta sharira anushtitam. One's own karma, one has taken anadi ananta sharira. Earlier, anadi. Ananta here is anadi sharira. The earlier janmas tending to ananta, meaning anadi. So, atita ananta sharira anushtitam. How many shariras were there earlier? Ananta shariras were there. That is the idea. It does not mean that shariras won't have ananta. How many were there? They cannot be counted. So, countless shariras were there earlier. And through those shariras, sharirahi, anantaihi sharirahi, yat anushtitam karma, that karma, so anushtitam sat, phalaya anarabdham. That karma is called as sanchita. Vartamana sharira kritam bhavishyat karma agami. Whatever karma is done, here there is a bheda. Some say, Tattva Bodha says, the jnani's agami karma is that karma which is done by the jnani after jnanutpatti. So that is the demarcation. Everything else is sanchita. Otherwise, vartamana sharira, whenever this sharira was born, all that karma is called as agami. This is a better paksha. Because there is no, we should not consider a unit of time, a marker in time as to jnana took place here. That is not right, because kala itself is in ajnana avastha. That kala need not be the demarcation. There need not be a demarcation on that kala which is mithya. So, vartamana sharira krutam bhavishyat karma agami. Vartamana sharira was there before jnana, which continues after jnana. Kala has no meaning, but sharira continues to be there. Thereby, vartamana sharira krutam bhavishyat karma agami. Whatever is done further is called as agami karma. Atita sharira krutam sat vartamana sharira hetu bhutam sharira arambakam karma prarabdham. So what is this prarabdha karma, which was the karma done by the earlier shariras or earlier sharira, one or many, and it is the hetu for this sharira. That is called as prarabdha. Tatra cha sanchitam jnanena vinashyati jnaninah atmani kartrutvadi bhrantya bhavat naivastyagami yattu jnaninah shariram janaitva tatstiti hetu bhuta bhikshashanadu pravartayati prarabdham tat antarena bhogam nakshiyate. So out of these three, what happens after jnana? Sanchitam jnanena vinashyati. Through jnana, sanchita is destroyed. Jnaninah atmani kartrutvadi bhrantya bhava. Since there is no bhranti of kartrutva bhoktrutva unto oneself in the sense of the tadatmya sambandha with the body, therefore, what happens? Jnani does not have naivasti, jnaninaha agami karma pi. So, agami karma is also not there for jnani. There is no claimant. Yattu jnanina shariram janayitva. Having brought about this jnani shariras, that karma, which is like a short arrow, tat sthiti hetu bhuta bhikshashanadav pravartayati, which prods this jnani to go for bhiksha, it causes hunger in that sharira, which is utpanna even before jnana. And it is not lying dormant like sanchita, it is active like a short arrow that will continue to prod this jnani to say, okay, go for bhiksha. He goes for bhiksha. You are thirsty, drink water, feeling cold, cover yourself up. So these are the basic examples. Everything else is a follow-on which will come up. So the other paksha will also come up later. So this is a bare minimum which prarabdha pushes. Thereby, prarabdham tat antarena bhogam rakshiyate. You cannot say jnani should not have hunger or thirst. He will have hunger or thirst. Thereby, he will take care of it just like a disease. Kvachitcha aparoksha anubhuti viveka chudamanyadi granthesu. Now, so far, Sadhu has quoted Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya exhaustively. So much so that most of this has basis in one or the other Panchadashi chapter. He has also taken cue from Jivan Mukti Viveka. However, in this case here, what does he do? Bhagavan Bhashyakara, Bhagavat Padacharya has written Aparokshanubhuti. And Viveka Chudamani also, what does he say? Earlier he said the Shankarananda and others. So Vidyaranyacharya is also included. By extension. But what does Vidyaranyacharya do? Panchadashi is across chapters. There is no anurti per se. There are some prakriyas which differ as well. Thereby, Panchadashi, each chapter may not have the exact same idea. There may be some contrast here and there. Because each chapter is independent. Can be independent. Now, Aparokshanubhuti, in that Grantha, it is said that Bhagavat Padacharya says that there is no Prarabdha also. Perspectives vary from whose perspective that Aparokshanubhuti Grantha is. From whose perspective it is said that Prarabdha isn't there. From Jnani's perspective. From the other's perspective, Prarabdha is there. So, Viveka Chudamani and Aparokshanubhuti, what do they say? Sanch and Adi, there are other Granthas also. Sanchita Agami Karma Bhavan Bhava Nyaya Balat. So, Sanchita Agami Karma Abhava is there. So, due to that, Sanchita Agami Karma Abhava Nyaya Balat Jnanina Prarabdham Api Naiva Sambhavati. So, they use Tarka and say that since Sanchita and Agami are not there, Prarabdha is also not possible for a jnani from jnani's perspective. Ataha bhojanadi pravruttirapi tasyena yujyate iti yad uchyate. Now, considering that if someone says that bhojanadi pravrutti is not possible for a jnani, jnani swarupataha brahma swarupa, being brahma swarupa, brahma is not having pravrutti in bhiksha ityadi. So, bhojana is not possible for brahma, that is the meaning there. Tatra ayam abhipraya. What is the idea there? Jnanina swadrushtya swatmani kriya tatpala sambandho nastyeva tasmat swakarma pratishedaha prarabdha pratishedascha swatmani kriyate natu jnanina sharire bhogam eva na utpadayati iti. It is not that jnani sharira will not have any bhoga under the influence of prarabdha. It only means that jnani being brahma in himself he does not have any of himself in the sense that he, she is for the lack of a better word. We use those pronouns in the language. However, Jnani is Brahma. In that Brahmatma, there is no pravritti possible. There is no hunger or thirst ityadi. Yataha jnanina sanchitam karma jnanina nashyati agaminastu karmana sambandha eva nasti prarabdham tu bhogata eva nashyati nanyatha ayam eva cha sutrakaradhya viprayaha. Therefore, what should be understood is that Sanchita Karma goes by Jnana. Agami is not claimed because after Jnana there is no Karta. So, there is no claimant. Therefore, that also goes away. Prarabdha, however, what happens? Unless there is Bhoga by that Sharira which is Utpanna, there is no possibility of it going away. This is what even Vyasacharya says in Brahma Sutra, that is the idea. Therefore, this is the agreeable thing as to Sanchita and Agami go away, but Prarabdha continues to be there. Tasmat Prarabdha Sharira Vashat Sharira Poshanadi Nirvahaka Kriyadishu Jnanina Pravrutti Syadiva. Therefore, for Sharira Sthiti, there will be Pravrutti of the Jnani as well. Anyatratu Nasyat. Elsewhere, in other than those Karyas, there won't be Pravrutti. So that is the idea, and then there is a long section. So this is 465, but there is a long tippana also. We'll see the tippana, how much we can in the next part. So we'll continue there. We'll stop here. I have overshot the time as well. Sukannityam Suprakasham Vyapakan Namarupi Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddher Drukyatvare Varma Param Sarvedanta Vidyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadevahannamattho Nityam Enishchitamutihi Tatsat. Any questions? नमस्ते।